name is Curtis Moore, and I'm the Director of Investor and Public Relations for Energy Fuels, Inc. We are a U.S.-based uranium mining company. We're traded on the Toronto Stock Exchange under the ticker symbol EFR, and also on the New York Stock Exchange under the ticker symbol UUUU. Well, we actually have, I would say, two flagship projects. Our number one flagship project would be the White Mesa Mill. This is the only operating conventional uranium mill in the United States. It's located in southeast Utah, near the town of Blanding, Utah. It's central to a lot of uranium resources in the Four Corners region of the United States, which are some of the best uranium mining districts in the United States. The White Mesa Mill produced 1.2 million pounds of uranium last year. In fact, that made Energy Fuels the second largest producer of uranium in the United States, second only to Cameco. There's a lot of resources in the area that allow us to increase production at White Mesa. In fact, White Mesa has the potential to produce up to 4 or 5 million pounds per year, so it has significant unused capacity. Our second major flagship project, I would say, would be our Wyoming projects. We have three large-scale projects in development in Wyoming. If you were to just consider those three projects, it would comprise a major uranium development and mining company just on its own. This includes our Sheep Mountain project, also our Gas Hills project, and our Juniper Ridge project. We're developing that area as a second major production center, which we would hopefully be up and running in the next 2 or 3 years. Well, I would say that the answer to that question is what we would term our unmatched potential to increase production over the next few years if the price of uranium comes back like a lot of us think it will. Right now, like I said, we did 1.2 million pounds last year. Now, in the current price environment, uranium is still a bit of a weak price, and we're actually looking to cut our production next year in a reaction to that. However, if the price were to rise significantly in the coming months, we could increase our production to 6 or even possibly 7 million pounds per year over the course of about 4 or 5 years. And there's really no other uranium mining company that we're aware of that could increase their production to that degree. So I think that is what differentiates Energy Fuels from a lot of our peers in this space. I think that a couple of the big catalysts would be, number one, Japan restarting some of their nuclear reactors. After they had their disaster, the earthquake and the tsunami, they shut down all of their nuclear reactors. They probably have 25 or 35 reactors that they could restart. 14 have applied for a restart, and a lot of analysts believe that some of those are going to restart in 2014. I think that'll be a nice catalyst for the industry. Secondly, there are 71 nuclear reactors under construction around the world right now. Those are all going to come online, and they're all going to require uranium. In fact, one of the two nuclear utilities in China announced that they're going to have 5 come on in 2014. And each one of those is going to require uranium. And in fact, they require more uranium for the initial cores. So I think once you see some of these new reactors come online, that's just going to increase the demand and be a nice catalyst for the uranium industry. I would have to say that the company I probably most admire is Uranerts. They are operating up in Wyoming's Powder River Basin. They are developing an in-situ project up there. They're looking to, I believe, have production here in 2014. And I just think they're doing a lot of the right things. I mean, in fact, things that I think that are similar to our company. For instance, they have a very important strategic relationship with Cameco. Like our company has important strategic relationships as well, like with Korea Electric Power Corporation, KEPCO, and Sumitomo. Again, I think that they're doing a lot of the right things, and they're poised for good things here in the future.